Hey guys, it's Chris. I'm here with your sacred partnership romance reading for Valentine's Day. And obviously, every day is love day, so to speak. So, we're looking at the energies that I feel like are between the full moon we had on Friday and the new moon that's coming at the end of the month and possibly beyond it. So think of the next 2 to 6 weeks. So these energies are in play for the next 2 to 6 weeks. Now I'm wearing my Valentine's Day color. All right. So I'm going to first start with the Romance Angels Oracle cards by Doreen Virtue. Really appropriate. So I'm going to do two rows, one for committed relationships and one row for single people. So how would I, committed relationships can be all different kinds of relationships where you're with someone and there's a commitment of any kind. So that includes open relationships. I have a lot of friends that are in open relationships, and that's a committed relationship. You're committing to having an open relationship. So then the other side is the single people are either, you know, casually dating, don't have any sort of agreements or commitments, or people who just haven't met the right person yet. So, I figured those would probably be the two categories that will, you know, basically be fairly universal. So I'm going to work on the first row for committed partnerships. See what comes through for love and sacred partnership and romance between now and probably mid-March. Let's see what comes up. And we had one eclipse Friday, full moon eclipse. So that was definitely changing things up. Maybe some surprises came up. Maybe some changes in direction in your relationships, or maybe not. And then we have another eclipse, a solar eclipse on February 26th. It's a new moon in Pisces, so there's going to be some stuff happening then. So I have a feeling a lot of what we're going to get today is going to be corresponding to that eclipse. Okay, so for committed relationships, I'm picking a card for overall energy, what is in alignment and what is in the flow, and what is out of alignment, what is blocked, and then how to clear blocks and get into alignment. Maybe I'll cut today. Okay, and then for each of these romance angel cards, I'm going to also use these angel oracle. My screen blacked out, so I want to make sure you can see this. The angel oracle cards by Doreen Virtue. These are going to be used as clarifiers. It looks like really good stuff happening in committed relationships for the next 4 to 6 weeks. It's looking good. Okay. So this is for committed relationships. The overall energies are reconciliation. Someone from your past is returning. And then the clarifier is if you believe. Interesting. So, obviously, you know, this is a general reading for a lot of different people and a lot of different situations. So, reconciliation from the get-go means, you know, reharmonizing. That's kind of how I see it. For some people, it could be someone from your past is returning. And you know, if you're in a committed relationship and you're attracted to somebody that returns from the past, and I've seen in other like astrology sort of forecasts that because Jupiter went retrograde February 9th in Libra. Libra represents partnerships of all kinds. That there could be people from the past. So it can mean, like, some people are like, oh, does that mean someone's going to have an affair? All that. So I don't want people to go to those places. But there's a few scenarios here. The first one is between you and your committed partner. You guys need to reharmonize your relationship. There's maybe been fighting or some sort of a disagreement, and the reconciliation is time is here, which is good. Another scenario could be that someone, a past lover, is coming back into your life for reconciliation. So maybe there's something that needed closure, and that's a good sign. You're going to get that closure from them. So I know some people are going to be asking, well, does that mean I'm going to hook up with a past lover? And the answer is maybe you will, if that's what is in alignment for you. And maybe, again, maybe it's just a conversation that you have with somebody. All right, so we're going to read from the card as well to see what they say. This card indicates that an ex-lover may be re-entering your life. The first person you think of is likely who it will be. The purpose of this reconciliation is to achieve healing and closure with respect to your past. You will understand more about yourself and see your relationship patterns more clearly. You'll also take responsibility for the role you played in the relationship's drama, which will free you from the tyranny of unforgiveness. Reconciliations are ultimately about taking care of unfinished business. This card could also possibly mean making peace with a family member or friend. Okay. And then the If You Believe card, really pretty card. I think what it's saying is have faith. Have faith in the healing potential of this reconciliation. It says, what you need right now is faith. You can have what you desire, but you must believe that it can be so. Stay positive and visualize the outcome you're hoping for. Set aside all negativity or pessimism in favor of a sunny outlook. The law of attraction brings to us what we expect to receive. If our perception is that we deserve great things, then we will attract happiness. If we fall into doubt and don't believe in our own self-worth, then our experiences will match that energy. Believe in yourself and your cherished dreams. Okay, so what is in the flow and what is in alignment for your relationship? It is safe for you to love. Open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of all. And your clarifier card in Angel Answers is improving health. So I think the theme that's coming up in these first two cards, ooh, and even later, it's all about healing. So it could be physical health, focusing on your physical body and, you know, right eating, right nutrition, supplementation, seeing the right health professionals. And also, I feel like health of your relationships, health of how you behave in a relationship, how your emotional health and mental health and spiritual health in regards to relationships. So I feel like this is a time, since this is showing flow and alignment, that you're really successful with opening your heart. You're really successful with focusing on healing. And I feel like what the angels are saying here is that you're not approaching this relationship from an ego state. It's really from a heart center. So that's really beautiful, that it's all about coming from your heart. It's all about a balance, giving and receiving, and I think you're going to open up even more. So if you've had any sort of maybe codependent behaviors or fears around abandonment relationships, or just being overall, just the wounded parts of yourself are healing. And that's great. Okay, so it is safe for you to love. Let me read this one. This card indicates that you're protecting your heart from hurt because of painful relationship experiences. However, the angels can only bring as much romance as you allow inside. If you have a shield around your heart, how is love to get in? A closed heart repels the sensitive partner you're trying to attract. Following your inner guidance will protect you and simultaneously allow you to feel loved and loving. Trust your intuitive senses with respect to other people's trustworthiness and open your heart to those who are kind and gentle. So again, this is in the position of what is in alignment. So I don't feel like your heart is closed off. I feel like you finally opened your heart. And I think that reconciliation kind of started the whole thing. Okay, and the next card is improving health. I'm going to read this very lovely, lovely card with this beautiful cup here right at the heart center. So again, open heart, another message of being an open receiver for love. And then we have the snakes intertwining, the caduceus, which is the sign of, you know, healing and health. That's pretty ancient. Okay, improving health. The angels want you to know that the health of the person you asked about is going to improve. You can request the assistance of Archangel Raphael and your guardian angels to speed along the recovery. This card may also be urging you to make more healthful choices in your life. If you're feeling called to detox from harmful foods or substances, you should follow that guidance. Removing unhealthy practices from your life will make you feel vibrant and strong. Again, these cards represent what's in the flow for you, for those of you who are in committed relationships. So I get that the improving health and the safe for you to love, the opening of the heart, all of that, it's definitely a lot about heart healing, but I feel like there's also a physical element that if you've been, you know, regenerating from an illness or, you know, had your heart broken in the past, and again, this kind of reconciliation energy, this retrograde energy may bring up those old feelings from those old wounds, or they may be triggered. So there's healing. So here is what is either blocking you, blocking the relationship, or what's keeping you out of the flow. The first card is attraction. You attract romantic love by being in this moment fully. The other one is called recovery. Look at that, another card about healing. Isn't that amazing? Okay, So, obviously, in this position, this is not necessarily the that you are living in the fully in the present moment. I think what this is saying is that maybe you aren't. And you're not fully maybe appreciating the relationship or not seeing all the beauty in it, not savoring it, like how she's, smelling these beautiful roses. Cultivating that sort of heart, open-hearted awareness and romantic sense takes time. And you have to go, you have to go slowly. You can't rush around life and go, oh, let's just see what happens. And let's just, I've got to stay. And this is also the person that is overworking themselves, perhaps. So this is kind of just showing you that there's more attention that needs to be paid. So attraction, attention, or attention to attraction. Getting in your body, getting out of your head. You might be in your head too much lately. Okay. Okay. So, like a good friend, the romance angel sends you this card to tell you the truth. The best way to have more romance in your life is through attraction rather than through strenuous effort. You are most attractive when you're fully enjoying yourself in the present. Your joyful laughter, self-expression, and body language are beautiful. In contrast, any stress you experience as you strain to find romance pushes against, the stream of life. Strain comes from a place of fear with an underlying worry. Maybe I won't receive this. So that fear can attract the very thing you worry about. So go smell a rose and fully enjoy its fragrant beauty. Allow yourself simple pleasures that lead to great joy. Affirm frequently that you are loved and lovable. Visualize a wonderful romantic relationship with a great partner. Take excellent care of yourself and follow your inner guidance. So, take care of yourself. There's another part of the message, being in your body, getting a massage. Maybe you and your beloved for Valentine's Day or any time in the next month, go get massages together, or just go to the beach together, go on hikes, getting out in nature, rubbing each other's feet, giving each other massage, all that good stuff. So recovery, really beautiful card here. And here's a woman, and again, she's very open-hearted, like her whole chest is showing. And then there's an angel behind her doing healing work on her. So recovery, you're recovering. Again, this is, I feel like it's both the body and also mending wounds, past wounds, and if you've had a broken heart, that being also on the mend. Okay, recovery. This is a period of recovery and healing for you. The challenging emotions that you've been dealing with will fade away with time. Although it may be difficult to see now, there is a joyful future awaiting you. But for now, take all the time you need to regain your strength. This card can also mean that your recovery is nearly finished or already complete. Send words of gratitude to heaven and begin planning for the next exciting phase of your life. Sorry, I've got burpees right now. That's about. Okay, so the next two cards are about how to, it's basically advice from the angels of how to unblock this area and get back in the flow, get back into alignment. And the first card is soulmate. Yes, this is your soulmate. Beautiful card. Yay. So I think I'm going to go back to this idea of appreciating the person that you're with, that this is a time where, and it could connect back to the reconciliation too, that, you're in a committed relationship, And depending on the different scenarios of reconciliation, you know, you could be with your soulmate or twin flame right now, and whoever comes back from the past could be another soulmate. It just gets too complicated. I'm not going to go there, but what I'm going to say is that what I feel with this card is this is somebody that you have a natural attraction to, a natural flow with. There's mutual love and respect. And it came next to this card, compromise. So look at, she's got those scales. So are you being fair in your relationship to yourself and to the other person? It could be that, you know, you're on the wrong side of the scales, that, you know what I mean? It may not be your partner. It might be that it's unbalanced in their favor and not in yours. So there's a balancing that's happening, and that's where I think most of the healing is taking place in your relationship. Let's see if anything else comes up. And Libra is also the sign of the scales. And yeah, so this is all about harmonizing and balance and healing that, bringing this back into your relationship. If it's been out of balance, if your lives have been kind of topsy-turvy, I think this is a month where you slow down, you focus on healing individually and healing with each other, opening your heart to each other even more. You know, like I said, spending time together in nature looks like might be part of this time too, especially now as we're going to get towards late winter and early spring. You'll have obviously more opportunities, but, you know, you have to make the opportunities to cultivate, you know, this garden of roses. That yes, you know, it's not about strenuous effort, but it's not about no effort. You know, there has to be a balancing. Okay, so I will read the Romance Angels card, Soulmate, from the book. You chose this card because you wonder if a certain person is your soulmate, and the answer is yes. As we all do, we have many soulmates, beings with whom you share a mystical soul connection and life path. Soulmates incarnate with the plan of coming together for mutual, spiritual, and personal growth. As you suspected, the person you're inquiring about is one of yours. That sense of familiarity and comfort you felt when you first met also indicates your soulmate bond. This card sometimes comes to those who ask, "When will I meet my soulmate, or will I ever meet my soulmate?" as validation that this will occur. Many times, this is a person whom you already know. Okay. So I feel like it's just confirming, the angels are confirming that this is a good relationship for you, that this is working for you, even if there have been some bumps in the road. Okay? And then compromise. Let me read that one. In order to create a happy outcome for the situation, you will find it necessary to compromise. Allow yourself some time to become clear about what is truly important to you. Also, take note of matters where you would be open to changing your position. Work towards an agreement where everyone wins. Be open to cooperation that would allow you to get what you need while also assisting others in fulfilling their desires. Be objective about finding a balance between respecting everyone else's viewpoints and still being true to your own. So yeah, we don't want to become the doormat that just is like, okay, well, I'm just going to give in and give you whatever you want. It's like, okay, well, what's really important to you and what's really important to me? And let's find the middle ground. Let's find ways to take care of each other's needs, to be able to fulfill each other's needs. Yeah, I feel like the next 4 to 6 weeks is going to be bringing you closer together bringing more harmony, bringing more healing. And there might be, like I said, someone coming back from the past for a reconciliation. And for those of you in that scenario, that it's going to be a really healing blessing to have this person come back and maybe, you know, tie up loose ends, give you closure, or give each other closure. In some cases, does it mean that it could rekindle love? It's possible. But I would say, since Jupiter's retrograde, take it slow. If it's somebody that's sparking your, you know, your romantic feelings, then yeah, you need to look at that. So what's going on? What is going on in your committed partnership that's leaving the door open for you to be attracted to someone else? But I feel like because the soulmate card came in, all of this is very kind of, it feels like destiny and fate. And it's all going to come to good. It's all going to be good. So again, focus on health, healing, being present with yourself and your partner, being open-hearted, having open-hearted discussions, being truthful about what you need, and then listen to what they need as well. Okay, so I'm going to do my next reading in the same way, but this is going to be for single people. So these are for those of you who are unattached. You could be casually dating or not doing much at all, or, you know, in a single phase. Maybe you're recently separated and you're not in a committed relationship anymore, then you are now single. Okay, so I'm going to shuffle these romance angel cards a little bit, and I'm going to cut them, and we'll see. What's going on for single folks? I'm going to cut these cards. So again, I'm reading for overall energy. What is in alignment? What's in the flow? What is out of alignment or blocking? And then how to clear these blocks and get back into alignment. Wow, interesting cards. Okay. And I'm going to do the same thing with the Angel Answers cards. I'm going to shuffle a bit. A little bit more, and then I'll cut them. Sorry, it's probably kind of boring. Okay, let's see. Okay. Wow. Pretty different cards. So I'm glad I did separate readings for single people versus people in committed relationships. Okay. So the first card that you got from the Romance Angels is forgiving and learning. Look at this. As you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moments. And then you got this card. There's something better. Okay. I'm going to look at these two together here, and you know, a lot of people have been releasing a lot since Friday, the February, was it 10th or 11th full moon in Leo, the lunar eclipse. I did some releasing ceremonies around past relationships. A lot of different people came up when I did my meditation. Because I felt like, you know, to move forward in love relationships, I was still like, I felt like I had cobwebs around me, like the energy. I wasn't clear. And in some cases, I hadn't taken responsibility for my part. You know what I mean? Where you're like, well, this person da-da-da-da-da, they did da-da-da-da-da. So what's your part in it? So I feel like that's what this is, forgiving and learning. So forgiving the other person, forgiving yourself, and learning the lessons from that, from the mistakes, not the mistakes, but from the whatever you had to go through. And taking ownership of your part. So I'm going to read the card for forgiving and learning. The romance angels have heard your desire for great love, and they bring you this card as guidance. They see that your heart can give and receive the bliss of romance by clearing away the cobwebs of the past. Okay, that's kind of scary. Okay. The angels know that you've been hurt before and that you're wary of being hurt again, yet your defenses are creating barriers to allowing love in your life. As you heal your past, you won't keep recreating it. After all, you attract into your life the situations and relationships that remind you of what you've already experienced, because that is a primary tool of healing. To change to a healthier relationship pattern, it's necessary to detoxify any old anger, blame, or unforgiveness that you may be holding. This includes forgiving yourself. If you call upon the angels and ask them to help you release and heal your past, they'll clear away the heaviness so that your heart can soar with happiness. So that's the overall energy for the next 4 to 6 weeks. So this might be happening for you as well, might be coming up for you. So there's something better. Heaven has something wonderful in mind for you. However, it's not the same thing you have planned. Ask yourself what you would rather have, the very thing you're asking for, or something that would make you much happier and more fulfilled. Sometimes God has joys in store for us that we could never imagine on our own. Open your mind and heart to the possibility that you deserve even more than what you're asking for. Trust your angels to guide you in new and exciting directions. So there you go. I think maybe I'll create a meditation for the single folks to work on releasing and cutting the cords and clearing away the cobwebs of the past and old relationships, because the angels are definitely sending you somebody, or you know, some better relationship, a healthier relationship than what you've had in the past. So that's really good news. Okay, so what is in the flow is romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. And then ask your angels. So romantic feelings. I have a sense that for singles, it could be that maybe you've been imagining like your next love, it's not necessarily even just imagination. You are like feeling somebody in your field, like they are coming, kind of like, or they're here, but you just haven't met yet and the timing isn't quite right. And then the ask your angels, ask your angels to get you ready to help lead you to this person. And it could also mean maybe that you met someone recently that you're like, huh, I kind of like that person. I wonder, you know, what the deal is with them. And maybe you found out they were single too, and you're like, okay, so what does that mean? So there's a couple of different scenarios here for this romantic feelings card. Okay, so the stirrings within your heart represent the song of romance calling to you. This card comes to you as guidance to follow the pathway of those feelings. Perhaps you've met someone who made your heart leap and you wondered whether to pursue him or her. Well, this card says that the answer is yes. Take action by flirting, asking the person out on a date, or making your feelings known. If you've recently been longing for more romance in your life, this card is a signal to take charge of making that happen. You can romance yourself, for example, by treating yourself to a luxurious massage or pedicure, buying yourself presents, or watching a romantic movie. You can also actively pursue and attract romance. First, affirm that it is already inside of you. A partner definitely brings these feelings to the surface. However, they were within you as a potential initially. The more you affirm, "I'm romantically loved," the more you attract this condition within yourself and through a relationship. In some cases, you'll receive this card as a signal that you're ready for a new relationship. It then guides you to take action, such as being aware of people you meet who may be potential partners, as well as frequenting places where such potential partners may be located. So these would be locations or events associated with your hobbies and interests. Okay, and now the Ask Your Angels card. Your angels are always with you. However, you must ask for their assistance in order for them to provide you with the help you're seeking, because heaven respects your free will choice. So true. State your questions to your angels clearly. You can do so either out loud or silently in your own mind. Your angels will instantly help you according to God's will. Your angels may also have special messages for you about the situation you're asking about. Sit quietly in a peaceful place, indoors or out in nature, and ask for advice and guidance. Notice what messages come to you. It's possible the answers will come to you through your feelings, hearing, or sight, or perhaps you will just know the answer. You can also ask the angels for signs during the day to guide you onto the right path. So ask them to guide you to this person that's in your field. There's somebody there. Okay, so this is what is the energy that is blocked or not in alignment. And the first one is honeymoon. Enjoy the bliss of holiday time together. And the other card is communicate clearly. Fascinating. I think ultimately what this honeymoon in the blocked position means is that I think you're having a hard time believing that you can have lasting love, or that, I don't think it's worthiness. And then you got to communicate clearly also here. Honeymoon card also has to do with meeting someone on a vacation. And then this communicate clearly card, kind of, I always think of Hawaii. I see these dolphins and this woman that kind of looks Hawaiian to me on the card. I feel like maybe you haven't had the time or the financial resources to travel and kind of get out of your everyday environment. I think that can be a block to like opening your heart and opening your mind to a new relationship or new people. Because one of the meanings of this card is when you're meeting somebody on a vacation, like in another country, or, you know, while you're hiking, you know. So I think that there's a block here about, I can't meet somebody new because of XYZ, And I think the XYZ might be that you feel like you don't have the time to meet someone, or you don't have the financial resources, or you're not ready. I'm feeling like an unsure energy. So like you're unsure maybe if you're ready for a relationship. And even though this might not be conscious, it's playing out unconsciously by blocking the flow. So blocking that flow to that honeymoon, blocking the flow to that vacation, that travel that you want to do, or the, it could even be moving to a different area. Like you might just have been feeling like, I live in the small Bohunk town and there's nobody here. You know what I mean? Just all those little reasons we give ourselves that, you know, we can't, you know, love is just not in the cards for us and blah, blah, blah. It's all about making excuses because you don't feel ready. So here's the honeymoon card. I'm going to read the meaning. This card indicates the need for a getaway to nurture romantic love. The specific application of this message depends upon the person who is inquiring. For some, this card has a literal meaning. You are going away with your new spouse following your wedding. Well, we're single, so that doesn't really apply. For those already in a long-time partnership, that doesn't apply. So it can also relate to the honeymoon period of a new relationship. And still for others, the card indicates that you will meet someone special while on a vacation. So I would say that the first two or the last two were probably what I would apply to this card. So, interesting. Okay, communicate clearly. This situation requires very precise and careful communication. Don't assume that others involved understand what you want or need for them. In-person discussions are preferable, but if that's not possible, make sure that your communication method is very thorough. This card can indicate that there has been a miscommunication that is creating a challenge for the parties involved. By clearing up any misunderstandings, you can heal the situation so that everyone can start moving forward again. Moving forward into the future. I mean, look at that. Under the full moon. And since we just had this full moon, maybe you were recently, on vacation and maybe, or just out and about, maybe in a different frame of mind. And maybe you met somebody and didn't really communicate that, oh, I'm interested in you, or there's some miscommunication. And I love the dolphins. Again, look at her face. It's just like, you know, just very Hawaiian looking to me. And, you know, we had the Ask Your Angels card. I think really sit down and maybe write down, this is why I can't find the right person, or this is why I feel hopeless about romance, or this is, you know, kind of try to dig into what you're really feeling negatively about and what's blocking you. So maybe that's what you're trying to communicate to yourself. And then you can turn those around and maybe even begin to communicate with your angels, or if there is someone in your field that you're feeling, you can communicate with them through the fifth dimension, through 5D. You know, it's not about just sending some random person an email, which, you know, I mean, maybe some of you are online dating and that's a possibility. Maybe this person lives in another town, another country, another state, and you want to try to actually meet in person. That could be another scenario. I didn't even think of that for people that are online dating. Or if you meet someone on Facebook, etc. Ooh, the plot thickens. Okay, so the next two cards are how to unblock the energy and come back into alignment and flow. Retreat. Oops, it's like doing it backwards. It's time to disconnect from the world. So not, it's a very similar card to the honeymoon card. It's pretty uncanny. And then helpful people is the answer here. So The retreat card. I feel like it is telling you that the single people to go within and meditate about what you really want. Retreat from the world, retreat from other people's opinions and what other people think or what society thinks, who they think you should be with. And again, it's also another card that's telling you to take a vacation. So changing the scenery, changing your point of view about things. Sometimes, again, we don't have the time or the money, or we're making excuses about that, so we can't get out of our normal surroundings. But I think that's what this is telling us to do for single people. And helpful people, well, that's kind of self-explanatory. There are people around you and possibly people coming to you in the next month, 4 to 6 weeks, who can really help you. Maybe they introduce you to one of their friends, or they invite you to a party, invite you to an event, a yoga class or whatever, and you meet somebody there. And just like, oh, bada bang, boom, you know, the lightning bolts all, you know, take off and stuff. So who knows? So I'm going to read this retreat card. Again, this is how to get unblocked, how to get back into alignment with romantic relationships. The romance angels see that your love life blossoms as you spend time alone with your partner or by yourself. So again, if you're casually dating, maybe this means like a little weekend getaway. If you're online dating, it could mean trying to get to where they are, trying to get them to where you are, any of those things. But I feel like this is about being physically present in the same room together. That's my sense. It appears that you've become confused or conflicted by other people's advice. It's time for you to disconnect so that you can better hear your own feelings and opinions. Okay. If you're in a partnership, this is not applying to you. So this could mean taking a vacation, going on a nature hike, enjoying a long drive, or turning off the phones and computer, and enjoying a quiet afternoon together. The painting on this card also indicates a honeymoon, which could be a literal message. So there may be a deepening of commitment or a new serious relationship if you're currently single. This card may indicate an upcoming engagement, wedding, or renewal of vows. Probably not if you're not quite attached to somebody, but you know, maybe you've been single for a long time dating somebody and not having a committed relationship with them, but all of a sudden now you decide together that you want a commitment. If you're presently single, this card guides you to spend time by yourself, meditating upon your true feelings and thoughts. Be sure to take action based on any intuitive guidance. This strengthens your energy, which helps you rapidly attract and manifest your loving partner. Awesome card. Okay, and helpful people. This card indicates that it's time to expand your circle of friends, or you may find yourself needing to do some professional networking. Make time to branch out in order to create the personal or career connections necessary to be happy and successful. This card can also indicate that your situation requires the input of those who can assist you in accomplishing the task before you. This may include professionals in fields related to your question or others who work for or around you. It could also include people in your personal life who have experience that would be useful. This card lets you know that someone will be entering your life soon who can make your dreams come true. So overall, for the singles, this reading is telling me that this is about preparing for new love. You know, it's coming. And it's coming probably in the next month, 4 to 6 weeks, next couple of months. So I would say by April, you could be, you know, in a relationship. Now, will it be a committed relationship or not? I can't tell you, but I feel like that whoever's watching this, that you're really ready for the one. You're ready for this person to come into your life. And they're saying the only way to do that is to clear out these cobwebs of the past. Just forgive yourself, forgive the other people that you've been in relationships with in the past, and let it go and take ownership and say, this is what I learned from this. This is what I'm taking as my responsibility in this relationship, what I did to create these circumstances. And then saying, I forgive myself completely. I forgive the other person completely. And there's all kinds of rituals and different kinds of meditations to do this. And I'm going to hopefully create one for you, because I feel like there's something that I'd like to create. And then there's somebody in your sphere, or somebody that you've just met, or you know that there is somebody that the love is around you and is being drawn to you. And you need to be really clear about what you want. Be really clear about how you might be blocking yourself. So just any sort of unconscious feelings of I can't do this, or I'm not ready. I think what it's saying is you are definitely ready, or you're getting ready. You're really close to being ready. And it's more about the timing. So in the next 6 weeks, everything's going to unfold naturally. Spend time in nature, try to go on vacation, try to whatever, take a trip to the next town, take nature hikes, go to the beach, change the scenery, get out of the house, meet helpful people, network, go out, do things that you normally wouldn't do maybe, and meet new people, new circles of friends. So whether or not, yeah, you find your love there, it may somehow connect you to your love. And in the meantime, you're going to make great new business friendships and personal friendships. So this looks like it's going to be a great, amazing time for the next 4 to 6 weeks for committed relationships and single people. It's going to be a lot of healing and a lot of moving towards what your heart really wants. Okay? Sending you guys so much love. Happy Valentine's Day and all that stuff. And celebrate Valentine's Day every day. Always be ready for love. Bye.